Hey, where are all my comic books?
Oh, those dreadful things. I gave those away.
Whoa. Thank you, Mrs. Parker.
Hello, Spider-Man fans. Thanks so much for clicking on this video. My name is Chris. Tom Holland last night went ahead and released this video on his Instagram.
Okay, so we just landed in Atlanta and it's time for Spider-Man 3. Let's go!
Your boy right there with you, Spider-Man 3. So I thought today, guys, what we'd go ahead and do is look at the 8 unanswered questions that we currently have going on in this current Spider-Man trilogy. What I mean by that is stuff that had been teased since the first Spider-Man movie and Spider-Man Homecoming that left unanswered, that now that we're getting into the third movie, and usually in the third movie, that's the closing chapter or the ending arc, we need answers to these mysteries, unanswered plot lines, and also things we've just been begging to see from the beginning of this new Spider-Man in the MCU. So I'm gonna need you guys to leave me your opinions down below. Out of all these 8 topics, do you think you can figure out what the answer will be in Spider-Man 3? Will they even address it in Spider-Man 3? Or if there was any unanswered questions or mysteries you have that I didn't put on this list, go ahead and let me know down below, because I'm sure there's still tons of stuff they didn't get to. As well as don't be forgetting to hit that like button, or right now you'll jinx it and Tobey and Andrew won't show up in it. So what? Hit like. Alright, so let's start off with one that had been teased in Spider-Man Homecoming that was actually a big plot point, is who bought Avengers Tower? Now, if you guys remember in Spider-Man Homecoming, it was a pretty big deal that Avengers Tower was being sold off. Happy Hogan was getting the place all ready and packed up to be moved to Avengers headquarters. And even all of us Spider-Man fans thought we would get the answer to who bought Avengers Tower in Spider-Man Far From Home. But again, all we got is a small little teaser that somebody was reconstructing the tower in the background while Spider-Man was swinging. Since this was a plot line and a mystery that was introduced in the Spider-Man movies, I would think they'd be addressed in the Spider-Man films and also would have a connection to our web-slinging hero. I think there's really only 3 answers that they can give to us in Spider-Man Something Homie. The first answer would be the Last Jedi theory, in where nobody important bought that tower. It was just something they introduced because they needed to move Avengers Tower, but nobody significant in the Marvel Cinematic Universe ended up buying that tower. And heck, it could be the new Sears Tower, could be the new Netflix Tower. Nobody important bought it, so it'll never be addressed again, but come on. I don't think people want us to get Last Jedi'd. My personal pick is the obvious, yes, make that Oscorp Tower. It's about time now in this third Spider-Man movie that you start reintroducing old villains that we got to see in other Spider-Man films. They've been mainly focusing on bringing us new villains to our attentions, which I'm very happy about that. But now that we know Jamie Foxx Electro is coming back, a villain that was previously used in other Spider-Man films, even by the exact same actor, all cards are off the table to now bring in old incarnations of new villains. And I'm dying to see what Norman Osborn, the Green Goblin, would look like for the MCU. And the only way to start that off would be to introduce Oscorp Tower taking over Avengers Tower. That's just like such a baller evil move for them to do. If not, they can continue some world building and introduce us to the Baxter Building, aka the headquarters for the Fantastic Four. Now, my money's still wondering whether they're going to introduce the Fantastic Four in a Spider-Man movie or in a Black Panther movie. It could kind of make sense because when Spider-Man finally got his own comic book series, one of his first issues was him teaming up with the Fantastic Four, and he's always been on and off with them. So having them buy out Avengers Tower wouldn't be that weird. But still, Spider-Man 3, we need to know who bought that tower. Don't leave us hanging. Another thing I think we're for sure getting the answer to, so there's not too much to worry about here, is Scorpion. I mean, again, this was a villain that was introduced in Spider-Man Homecoming. He was the ending teaser. It would be expected that he shows up in the second Spider-Man movie, but he was all forgotten, and now we need to finally have some closure on this villain for Spider-Man 3. Now, I like Scorpion as much as the next guy, but I do think it was an odd villain for him to be set up at the end of the first movie, like he's some sort of big Thanos for Spider-Man. And I think there might be some disappointment if Scorpion is used as an opening villain, sort of like Batrop the Leaper in Winter Soldier, where yeah, we got the ending teaser of him in Spider-Man Homecoming, and we eventually have to address it, but it'll just be something quick, fast, and Spider-Man will take him down. I would like that teaser to be extended out and him being one of the first members of the Sinister Six for the MCU. But at the same time, it makes perfect sense why he waited all this time to try and go after Spider-Man, because we know in that ending teaser, all he wanted to know is Spider-Man's true identity. And now that that is public knowledge, it's only a matter of time before he puts on the green tentacle suit and go after him. Only question is, who is giving him that green tentacle suit. The next thing I wonder about Spider-Man 3 is Peter gonna use Stark tech again? Now yes, go ahead and call me one of those whiny baby Spider-Man fans who just did not love that this version of Peter Parker has an over-reliance on technology, and even at times I'll consider him to be Iron Man Jr. But still, by the end of Spider-Man Far From Home, Peter Parker is essentially given the keys to Stark Industries. Not saying he's gonna be CEO or running the company, but anything that Tony Stark had at his disposal, which was his technology, his AI, his suits, Peter Parker now has access to all of that and can make a brand new suit whenever he wants, make a new gadget whenever he wants. Basically, money is not a problem for Peter Parker anymore because he has that Tony Stark blanket of Edith. With him being on the run and needing as much help as he can get, is Spider-Man going to be using Stark technology again to his advantage? I would want Spider-Man 3 to just firmly put it to rest whether Peter is actually going to be using this technology, if he's going to go all out with it, or if he is just putting it to the side and not touching it again. Maybe Pepper Potts, who's the head of Stark Industries, goes ahead and says that, sorry, Tony shouldn't have let you have that and we're taking it away from you. But speaking as a Spider-Man purist, one thing I do just want to know about in this world is, what was his Uncle Ben like, man? In this third Spider-Man movie, are we finally gonna get the origin story of Spider-Man that we've been wanting to see? Now, I know we've seen the origin of Spider-Man countless times, but I would not be opposed at all to a flashback scene to dorky Peter Parker, to a Peter Parker before these powers, to a Peter Parker on how he got these powers, to the relationship he had with Uncle Ben in the universe before he became Spider-Man. I just kind of find it wild that the word Uncle Ben is almost like the word Voldemort in the Spider-Man franchise, in where they have never said it at all, and in a way kind of pretend like he wasn't there. I know the MCU's version of Uncle Ben is Tony Stark for Spider-Man, and while I can understand that and I'm okay with that to a mentor standpoint, Tony Stark taught Spider-Man how to be a better superhero, but Uncle Ben taught Peter Parker how to be a good person in general. So I would love it in the third Spider-Man movie if they weren't afraid to go to the actual roots of Spider-Man and show us his upbringing. One jaw-dropping Easter egg that we got in Spider-Man Homecoming was Miles Prower, played by Donald Glover, going ahead and letting it drop that he has a nephew, aka Miles Morales. Like, the fact that they technically introduced Miles Morales into the MCU and is already out there, but we have not seen any sign of him, is kind of crazy to me. In Spider-Man 3, I think it's time you start planting the seeds for the character of Miles and whether he's actually gonna put on the Spider-Man suit, whether he's had his origin, and if we're gonna see more of that character in live action form instead of it was just a random Easter egg that'll never be addressed again. Because in the world the MCU has set up, there are a lot of ways for Miles Morales to be perfectly fitted for the MCU. We don't even know if he was snapped away during the blip, so is he older than he was when he was mentioned in Spider-Man Homecoming, or did he disappear and he's the exact same age? For all we know, in Spider-Man Homecoming, when the Prowler went ahead and said he had a nephew, he could have been 1 year old, he could have been 2 years old, and then through the course of everything that's happened, plus the 5 years in the blip, now we have a Miles Morales that could be 7-8 years old. And for the Spider-Man that we currently have in this universe, that leaves Peter Parker to be a good mentor. I mean, this guy has been mentored by all the Avengers. It's about time he mentors somebody else. Next mystery I have here might seem a little redundant or dumb, but hear me out on this. Why does J. Jonah Jameson hate Spider-Man? Now, I know we got that ending teaser in Far From Home that kind of gives us a good idea why J. Jonah goes ahead and hates the character of Spider-Man. And that's because in his mind, he saw Mysterio as an actual hero who died at the hands of Spider-Man. But it leaves me to wonder, what are J. Jonah's thoughts on the rest of the Avengers and superheroes going around in the world? Does he only hate Spider-Man, or does he also hate the Avengers, Tony Stark, Iron Man, Captain America, Hawkeye? Even attached to that, is J. Jonah Jameson going to be playing a bigger role in Spider-Man 3? There's got to be more announcements or news flashes being made throughout the movie. Heck, even bringing it back to one of my earlier questions, J. Jonah Jameson could be the one to finally introduce us to the Spider-Man origin story of Uncle Ben. Because once you know Peter Parker is Spider-Man, as a good journalist, or even though this guy's a bad one, he would do all the digging he can on this individual Peter Parker, and he'll find out, one, his parents died long ago in a car crash, unless the MCU decides to change that, and two, his Uncle Ben died as well, giving us how he died and an explanation to what happened to Peter when he first started being Spider-Man. Probably one of the biggest questions we recently just started wondering about Spider-Man 3 is, what is Electro's origin? A lot of us Spider-Man fans are still very confused at how they could bring in Jamie Foxx's Electro as a completely different version of Electro than the Electro he was in Amazing Spider-Man with Andrew Garfield. Jamie Foxx already went ahead and confirmed that he's not going to be blue, kind of inferring that this will be a completely new interpretation of Electro. So what is this man's origin? Are they going to give us the typical Tony Stark employee who was hated, mistreated, and by association just hates Spider-Man as well? I just really hope this time around the villains in Spider-Man 3 have a much better reason to be going after Spider-Man and their motivations are more clear other than the fact of I hate this guy and you're friends with this guy. But even after all that, if Marvel, you decide to answer none of these questions and just leave them in the dark and completely forget they exist, at least answer this one for us. Will the Spider-Verse happen? It's the rumor that gets wilder and wilder by the week, just the continued amount of guessing and prediction fans and other news sites have had about what is going to be happening in Spider-Man 3 or possibly leading us to a live-action Spider-Verse, including Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield. In Spider-Man 3, we just need the confirmation whether this is something we're actually eventually going to see, whether it be in Spider-Man 3 itself or it's going to be teased to be further expanded in later movies. As crazy of a Spider-Man fan I am, and as badly as I want to see these three guys on screen together, I would rather it be a setup in Spider-Man 3. That way they can have an entire movie of this Spider-Verse event or expand it out even further, instead of what the rumors currently say, where these guys will show up at the end of Spider-Man and they'll do the whole Spider-Man event towards the end of Spider-Man 3. Like, no, if you're gonna do this, make it a whole damn event. Don't be doing this like you did Venom in Sam Raimi's Spider-Man 3, where he's just shooting at the end of the movie. But I think us as Spider-Man fans, if we go in watching Spider-Man 3 and there is no answer or hint to the Spider-Verse in live action happening, we all set ourselves for disappointment. But that is just some unanswered questions or mysteries currently going on in the Spider-Man universe that I would really want answered in Spider-Man 3. Like I said, if you guys have an answer down below, go ahead and give me your prediction. Or if you have a different question or mystery that's going on in the franchise that you need answered, let me know also down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter at 3CFilmReview. As always, I'm Chris. Take care.